Good morning. Today we'll start with gas powered cycles. We will start with the ideal jet propulsion cycle. Gas turbine engines are widely used to power aircraft because they are light and compact and have a high power to weight ratio, means their power out is more as compared to their weight. Aircraft gas turbines operate on a open cycle called jet propulsion cycle. The ideal propulsion cycle differs from the simple ideal Brayton cycle in that the gases are not expanded to ambient atmosphere in the turbine. Instead, they are expanded to a pressure such that power produced by the turbine is just sufficient to drive the compressor and the auxiliary equipment such as the small generator or hydraulic pumps. That is, the net work output of jet propulsion cycle is zero. Means in case of a jet propulsion engine, the turbine power is used to run the compressor and the thrust, or you can say produced by the gases, is used to propel the your aircraft. So you can see this is your turbine, this is the nozzle. So this is high velocity gases which will actually propel the aircraft. Also, aircraft gas turbine operate at higher pressure ratios, typically between 10 and 20, and the fluid passes through a diffuser first, where it is deactivated and its pressure is increased before it enters the compressor. So this is the basic component of a turbojet engine. The first component is your diffuser here, from 1 to 2, which is the pressure rise in the diffuser, and from 2 to 3 is your compressor here, and from 3 to 4 is your heat addition at constant pressure, which is burner section. 4 to 5 is your turbine, and from 5 to 6 this is your nozzle. So from further gases will expand in the nozzle. The net output of a jet propulsion cycle is zero. The gases that exit the turbine at a relatively high pressure are subsequently accelerated in a nozzle to provide the thrust to propel the aircraft. Also, aircraft gas turbine operate at higher pressures. So typically diagram is shown in below, we had discussed earlier. The schematic of turbojet engine on TS diagram of ideal turbojet cycle is also shown in the diagram. So this is your typical TS diagram. In the ideal case, the turbine work is assumed to equal to compressor. Also, the processes in the diffuser, the compressor, the turbine and nozzle are assumed to be isentropic. In the analysis of actual cycles, however, the irreversibilities associated with these devices should be considered. The effect of the irreversibilities is to reduce the thrust that can be obtained from the turbojet engine. The thrust developed in a turbojet engine is the unbalanced force that is caused by the difference in the momentum of the low velocity air entering the engine and high velocity exhaust gases leaving the engine, and is determined from Newton's second law. The pressure at inlet and the exit of turbojet engine are identical. The ambient pressure, thus the net thrust developed by engine is, that is, force is equal to m dot v exit minus m dot v inlet. So this is the thrust generated by your gases, where v exit is the exit velocity of exhaust gases and v inlet is the inlet velocity of the air, both relative to the aircraft. M dot is taken as the mass flow rate of air through the engine, although we add fuel, but air fuel mass ratio used in jet propulsion engine is usually very high, making this difference very small. The power developed from the thrust of the engine is called propulsive power, Wp dot, which is propulsive force thrust times the distance. This force acts on the aircraft per unit time, that is the thrust times the aircraft velocity. So whatever the power is, propulsive power is equal to force, which we have calculated earlier, multiply the velocity of aircraft, which is m dot v exit minus v inlet into v aircraft. The net work developed by a turbojet engine is zero. Thus, we cannot define the efficiency of turbojet engine in the same way as a stationary gas turbine engine. Instead, we should use the general definition of efficiency, which is ratio of desired output to the required input. So desired output is the propulsive power and input is the heat supplied in the terms of fuel, that is Q dot in, means how much mass rate of fuel is added multiplied by calorific value. So this is your propulsive efficiency of the turbojet engine. Propulsive efficiency is measure of how efficiently the thermal energy released during the combustion process is converted to propulsive energy. So this diagram here showing that we had supplied fuel Q in, part of fuel is lost in the form of thermal energy, which is taken by exhaust gases. Kinetic energy, excess kinetic energy at the exhaust is also lost, and propulsive power is the output which we need. So this part is lost in the environment. modification to turbojet engine. Turbojet previously used for high speed jet, but for commercial purpose we need a performance, and we need also that less amount of fuel will produce more power. The first airplane built were the propeller driven with propellers powered by engine, essentially identical to automobile engines. The major breakthrough in commercial aviation occurred with the introduction of turbojet engine in 1952. Both propeller driven engines and jet propulsion driven engines have their own strengths and limitations, and several attempts have been made to combine the desirable characteristics of both in one engine. Two such modifications are propeller jet engine and turbofan engine. The most widely used engine in aircraft propulsion is turbofan or fan jet engine, wherein a large fan driven by the turbine forces a considerable amount of air through a duct surrounding the engine as shown in figure. So this is here, you can see here this compressor or this turbine, it will run a fan, this fan. So the fan exhaust leaves the duct at a higher velocity, enhancing the total thrust of engine significantly. So this fan will increase the velocity of air, and this extra air will go also from this side, and the rest will air go for the combustion purpose. So a turbofan engine is based on principle that for the same power, a large volume of slower moving air produces more thrust than a small volume of fast moving air. So we use the fan, so more amount of air will come into this engine, and the larger amount can produce a larger mass of flow rate of air. Also we can produce same thrust as compared to lesser mass with the larger velocity. So a turbofan engine is based on this principle. So the first commercial turbofan engine was successfully tested in 1955. So this is your a modern jet engine used to power Boeing 77 aircraft. This is a Pratt Whitney turbofan capable of producing 80,000 pounds. So you can see here, this is the fan here, which is used to you can see run the extra mass flow rate of air. So this is here low compressor, then you have high stage pressure compressor, then this is the combustors, these are the combustion chambers, and then this is a two stage high pressure turbine, this is low pressure turbine to turn inner shaft, so thrust will come from here. Next is a turboprop engine. In turboprop, instead of turbofan we use a propeller which is open to the atmosphere, and it is higher in diameter, and it is out of the casing. So this is compressor, burner and turbine. So a turbofan engine on an airplane can be distinguished from the less efficient turbojet engine by its fan fat cowling covering the large fan. All the thrust of turbojet engine is due to exhaust gases leaving the engine at about twice the speed of sound. In turbofan engine, the high speed exhaust gases are mixed with the lower speed air, which result in considerable reduction in noise. Means whatever the air which will come from this fan, means this air and this exhaust gas are mixed, which will reduce the noise level as well as the exhaust temperature of the air also, which will increase the overall efficiency of the engine. So in turbofan engine, the high speed exhaust gas are mixed. New cooling techniques have resulted in considerable increase in efficiency by allowing gas temperature at burner exit to reach over 1500, which is more than 100 degree above the melting point of turbine blades. Turbofan engines deserve more of a credit for success of jumbo jet that weigh almost 4 lakh kg and are capable of carrying over 400 passenger for up to distance of 10,000 km at speeds over 950 km per hour with less fuel per passenger mile. The ratio of mass flow rate of air bypassing the combustion chamber to that of air flowing through it is called bypass ratio. The first commercial high bypass ratio engines had a bypass ratio of 5. Increasing the bypass ratio of turbofan engine increases thrust. Thus it makes sense to remove the cowl from the fan. The result is the propjet engine. Means if you remove this turbo instead of this casing, if you open this casing, so then it will become a turbofan engine, propjet engine. The turbofan and propjet engine different primarily in their bypass ratio, which is 5 or 6 for turbofans and as high as 100 for propjet. A journal rule, propellers are the more efficient than jet engines, but they are limited at low speed and low altitude operations since their efficiency decreases at high speed and altitudes. The old prop jet engines were limited to speeds of about Mach 0.62 and at to altitude of around 90-100 meter. The new prop jet engine are expected to achieve speeds of about Mach 0.82 and altitudes of about 12,200 meter. Commercial airplanes of medium size and range propelled by turbofans are expected to fly as high as fast as planes propelled by turbofans, and to do so on less fuel. Another modification that is popular in military aircraft is the addition of afterburner section between the turbine and the nozzle. Whenever a need for extra thrust arises, such as for short takeoffs on combat conditions, additional fuel is injected into the oxygen-rich combustion gases leaving the turbine. As a result of this added energy, the exhaust gases leave at a higher velocity, providing a greater thrust. Ramjet engine is a properly shaped duct with no compressor or turbine, as shown in figure 95, and it is sometimes used for high-speed propulsion of missiles and aircraft. The pressure rise in engine is provided by the ram effect of incoming high-speed air being rammed against a barrier. Therefore, a ramjet engine needs to be brought to a sufficiently high speed by an external source before it can be fired. So this is a ramjet engine here. There is no moving part here, neither compressor, neither turbine. So air will come due to the rammed effect and it will raise to higher pressure. This is your fuel nozzles and this is your flame holders, and then it will pass through this nozzles. So this is a typical example of ramjet. The air gas turbine engine and its operation. So because there is no compressor, so either for the starting purpose, either they have to supply with a compressed air supply, or they will launch at a higher speed, means the initial speed has to be provided. So they are mostly suitable for missiles, and if they are used for aircraft, means the aircraft in the starting need to be supplied with the high pressure air. The ramjet performs best in aircraft flying above Mach 2 or 3. In the ramjet, the air is slowed down to about Mach 0.2, fuel is added to air and burned at this low speed, and the combustion gas are expanded and accelerated in the nozzle. Scramjet engine is essentially a ramjet in which air flows through a supersonic speeds above the speed of sound. Ramjets that convert to scramjet configuration at speeds above Mach 6 are successfully tested at speeds of about Mach 8. Finally, a rocket is a device where a solid or liquid fuel and oxidizer react in a combustion chamber. The higher pressure combustion gases are then expanded in nozzle. The gases leave the rocket at a very high velocity. So we can take the limitation of air out, means there is no need for compressor. We can directly mix hydrogen and oxygen, or you can say we can directly mix fuel and oxidizer, and that will become a rocket. So this is up to here about the aircraft engine, which is turbofan, turboprop, your ramjet and scramjet engine. Subscribe this channel, like this video, and thank you for watching this video.